We'd all love to become less dependent on our phone chargers, but current wireless charging options just aren't there yet. So what if we could charge our phones with Wi-Fi? Wireless charging devices on the market now use something called electromagnetic induction. First, a coiled wire in a charging pad turns an electric current into a magnetic field. Then, that field is received by another coiled wire in your device that turns it back into electricity and charges the battery. But most of the inductive charging devices we have today require direct or very close contact between the device being charged and the source of the magnetic field, which doesn't do much to resolve that feeling of being tethered to an outlet. And while some researchers are looking for ways to extend the distance of magnetic induction, others are instead looking at how radio frequency signals, like Wi-Fi, could be used to do the same thing. To clarify, this isn't new. Researchers have been working on it for a while now, and charging via radio frequency, or RF signals, actually works pretty similarly to magnetic induction. First, a transmitter, think your Wi-Fi router, sends out an RF signal. Then, a specially designed rectifying antenna, or Rectenna, in your device picks up that signal and converts it into an electric current. This is a super promising technology, but there are some drawbacks that have made developing it challenging. The first being charge. Current Wi-Fi routers don't emit that much power, and so would be limited to charging low-power devices like sensors or fitness trackers. And that would be awesome for applications like the Internet of Things, which is, hold on a sec, I've got unlimited data with Visible, so let me get a definition for you. Which is the networking capability that allows information to be sent to and received from everyday objects and devices using the internet. But making RF charging work for things like our phones will likely involve setting up a new type of RF transmitter, as well as installing Rectennas in any device we want to charge. That also presents a bit of the chicken or the egg dilemma. Do you install the Rectennas first or the transmitters first? Then there's the issue of distance. The farther away from the transmitter you get, the less power you'll be able to pick up. Finally, all of these systems need to get agencies like the FCC to say that they're safe before they can be sold to consumers. And that can take a lot of time. But despite all of these challenges, we're seeing a lot of progress. One company called ASIA has developed an RF receiver and transmitter duo called CODA. The receiver in, let's say, your phone, first sends beacon signals in various directions around the location you're in. Then the transmitter picks up these signals and then responds by sending concentrated RF waves along the same path, thus charging your phone. This helps provide more energy to the device than other systems, since you have a focused RF signal instead of casting the power over a large area. ASIA also debuted a new phone case and transmitter combo at CES this year that allows for continuous phone charging at up to 12 feet, but it's just a proof of concept. Another promising design is from a company called Energys. Their technology called Watt Up can charge small devices with RF energy at a distance of 3 feet, and it's already gotten FCC approval. And they also have a newer version in the works that claims to charge more devices at a new distance of 15 feet. Even more, a new study from MIT has found a way to make Rectennas flexible and do it with cheaper materials, which could mean wearables powered by Wi-Fi? All in all, it doesn't seem like we're that far off from real wireless charging at a distance and ditching those phone chargers once and for all. So what do you guys think? Would you buy one? Well, what about buying a new provider? Visible is the new way to think about phone service. No stores, no annual contracts, no hidden fees. Just 40 bucks a month for unlimited messages, minutes, and data at speeds of up to 5 megabits per second. All on Verizon's 4G LTE network. When you think the future of phone service, think Visible. Don't forget to subscribe for all your energy science needs. And for more on the future of wireless charging, check out this video. And one last thing. We only had time to talk about induction and RF charging, but some researchers are also working on wireless charging with infrared light. Man, the future is gonna be awesome. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.